Gonzaga is out for the first main event of the night. Nick D'Andrea taking a little bit of an early lead, followed by the 10-8 of Jimmy Asher. As they go three wide in the hairpin, McKenna Cox stuck in the middle. As they make it through cleanly for the most part, it is Nick D'Andrea followed by Jimmy Asher and Tanner Emery, 1-2-3 so far. Mike Jensen looking to the outside, possibly going to make it three wide with Ryan Hasselflucht and Jamie Corbett. As the 84 and 24 are going to go sideways in front of the whole field. Tough break for McKenna Cox and Stephen Dawson. As he's going to back up the rest of the field. As they try to merge back in, they go four wide. A little bit of contact with Jamie Corbett, who is currently second place. And that's going to allow Cole Roden, who is your points leader, to go to the outside. As they're going to look to make a three wide with Ryan Hasselflucht in the 33. And Jay Grant's going to pull it off, a little bit of damage on his left front after a little bit of contact going through the hairpin. But meanwhile, your top five, a little bit of a gap. That is Nick D'Andrea, Jimmy Asher, Tanner Emery, Gabe Gabor, and Bert Jacobs. And we got some of our bigger names trying to make their way through the field. As we have Brandon Terrio, Mike Jensen, Callum Miller right there battling it out around the 10th position. As well as Jamie Corbett, Cole Roden, McKenna Cox are right there. As it is going to be a really tight points battle for the championship between that 76 and that 15. So watch them mid-pack as Jimmy Asher gets around the 6 for the lead. Tanner Emery making a little bit of contact with the 0-2 of Gabe Gabor. That's going to kind of back everyone up. Tanner Emery is going to advance to the second spot. Gabe Gabor and Nick D'Andrea battle out for second. And Royce Tanner with 23 starting to gain ground on that top five. As Gabe Gabor is going to advance into the second spot, Tanner Emery falls to third. Nick D'Andrea fourth. Bert Jacobs fifth. Then we got Royce Tanner, Brandon Taylor, Tom Hughes all right there, bleeding down the back. As possibly some troubles, maybe a little of a misshift from 319 of Bert Jacobs going down the back shoulder there. That's going to allow Rose Tanner to get to the outside. As that is quite a tight battle right there for that 5th, 6th, 7th spot. Still 24 laps remain for the Interstate Battery Hornets, a main event. As trouble again for Bert Jacobs going down the back shoulder there, another misshift. Going to save a bunch of momentum. He loses three spots going down the back straightaway alone. Calvin Miller looking to make it four. Tough break for Bert Jacobs after a strong start to this race. As the 77 is slow up in turns three and four. Problems for Miller as well. But up front, Jimmy Asher, a very comfortable lead over Gabe Gabor and Tanner Emery. Here comes Royce Tanner and Brandon Taylor, two drivers that are in the top five of points. As they still have plenty of time to track down your leaders. As well as Jamie Corbett, Mike Jensen. They're hanging around too, not too far back. Only about 10 seconds, not even that, from the races. They go three wide down the back straight. That's Calvin Miller, Nick D'Andrea, and Mike Jensen. Going into turn number three, they get it sorted out before the apex, as the 102 goes off and the 9 introduces himself into the tires over on the gravel after the hairpin. And Nick D'Andrea makes contact with the loop tire going into the S. A little bit of carnage for drivers. And the 9 is still stuck. That is Mike Dur-